Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to do VLOOKUP in a flash. I'm just going to go over the real basics of using VLOOKUP. If you're using a version of Excel prior to Excel 365, like say you're using Excel 2019, then you're going to want to use the VLOOKUP function. So what does VLOOKUP do? VLOOKUP searches for a value in the first column of a table or an array, and it returns a related value in the same row from another column to the right in that table array. So let's look at the formula and the arguments. The VLOOKUP formula takes four arguments: the lookup value, the table, the column index, and the range lookup. So another way of looking at this is VLOOKUP is looking for this value in this list and get me the value from this column, and I am looking for an exact match or not. If I'm looking for an exact match, I want this to say false. Okay, so today we have a spreadsheet for prom season. Right here in column A, we have the amount that's been paid by each person. So they've either paid $50 or they've paid nothing. And then we have a list here of the people who are attending. So in this column, I would like a quick way to look up whether or not the number in this column is zero. And if it is zero, I'd like to return the name. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to type equals VLOOKUP and a left parenthesis. And I'm going to do this in cell C2. Now the first argument this is asking for is what lookup value am I looking for? In this case, I only want to look up a zero because I only want to return the people who have not paid. After I hit the zero, I'm going to put a comma, and my next argument it will ask me for is my table array. Where am I looking up this data? In this case, I want to look only in this row right here from A2 to B2 because I want to look in A2 and see if this is a zero, and if it is a zero, I would like to return this name. The value that I am looking up has to be in the first column of the range that I am looking up, and then I can return anything to the right of that. My next argument is what column index number do I wish to return? Do I want to return the information in column A or in column B? I want to return the information in column B because that's where the name is. A is column 1, B is column 2. So what I'm going to say in this case is a 2. And then I'm going to put a comma, and my last argument is, do I want an approximate match or an exact match? In this case, I definitely want the exact match, so I'm going to put false as this argument, and then I'm going to hit enter. And when I look at this, I'm going to get a value of not available because I have not found a zero in column A, and that is correct. The return of NA can be a little bit undesirable, and this functionality has been improved upon with XLOOKUP, because with XLOOKUP you can choose a custom error message to display when you can't find a match, whereas with VLOOKUP it's already determined that it's going to be \N/A. So I'm going to copy this formula all the way down using this little square here. I'm going to hold my left mouse button down and just drag all the way to the end of my data set. And when I let go, I can now look. If there is a name returned, there is a zero in this column. I'm going to check that for the rest of them. If there is a zero in column A, there should be a name in column C. So in this case, it works. In this case, there's a 50, so I shouldn't be returning anything. Same here. Emily has paid $0 as well as Isabella and so on. So when I look at this, a name is returned when someone has not paid, which is exactly what I wanted to do. Okay, with the version of VLOOKUP that we just did, you could also have used an if statement to calculate the fields that we calculated. But right here, I want to show you how we can look up in the entire table array. So what I did was I'm now asking the question, who is this person's date? And I'm putting a person into this cell right here, and I want to look up this person in column B, and I want to return their date in column C. And I want to be able to change who this person is so that I can quickly look up who they are bringing. So in order to do that, I'm going to click on the cell underneath the name and type equals V lookup and a left parenthesis. So my first argument again is, what do I want to look up? This time I'm going to pick this cell is what I want to look up. What is the table array that I would like to look up my information? I'm going to start with who's attending and make sure I get their date column. In this case, the value that I'm looking up has to be in the first column of my range. So in this case, it has to be in column B, and then I need to return a value that is to the right of column B. The next question I have is, which column do I want to return? I'm going to want to return column number 2. And finally, I'm going to use false for this last argument. And when I hit enter, I get Emily's date. And if I look over here, it is Matthew. Now if I change the name up here, I could type in Emma, and I would see that Emma is going with Joshua. Is that true? Yes. And I could also go up here and type Ethan, and I would be returned with Abby, and that would be true too. So this gives you more of an idea of the VLOOKUP function and how you can look up with an entire table of information. So in review, you can use VLOOKUP to look up a value in one column and return what's in the second column. The arguments used in VLOOKUP are what to look up, where to look that information up, which column should be returned, starting with the number 1, and then do you have an approximate match? Is that true or false? And in most cases, you want that to be false. I hope you learned enough about VLOOKUP today to help you get started. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to get notifications of new weekly Excel tips. See you next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.